Tell me about the children. Dr. Halsey.
You already know everything.
You kidnapped them.
Children's minds are more easily accepting of indoctrination. Their bodies more adaptable to augmentation. The result is the ultimate soldier. And because of our success, when the Covenant invaded, we were ready.
My father, Alex Mason, gave up everything he had. He abandoned me so he could defend his country from people like you. I hated him for that. But now, here I am. With you.
So we are the same, David. Shaped by those we have lost.
I throw this to the wind.
The Master Chief is dead.
His file reads missing in action.
Catherine. Spartans never die.
Your mistake is seeing Spartans as military hardware. My Spartans are humanity's next step. Our destiny as a species. Do not underestimate them. But most of all, do not underestimate him.
Welcome to Open Forum Radio, episode 124, season 3, episode 40. It is November 13th, 2012, 8 o'clock in the Central Standard Time. I am one of your hosts tonight, TJTMOHU87, but also with me, back with me, is Bill Vladz Hammer.
What's up, Timo? How you doing?
All right, man. It's been a long time, man. And I'm glad we're back home.
It has been. It's like 2 weeks. It seems like ten years.
Exactly, man. It's time to get some OFR goodness in for you tonight.
That's right.
As we don't have Jimmy the Ace Black, but understandable circumstances. We're going to have prayer for his wife because he thinks he might be having his boy tonight. So prayers go out to him and his family. But also, there's no Blue, and there's no Big Joe, but Big Joe is helping those people out putting power on because of Sandy. So we're sending prayers out for him as well as a happy return safe home. But hey, you got me and Vlad tonight, and I tell you
what,
that's enough. So as we get into our hot minute, as Bill has a rant about midnight launches and Best Buy. Why don't you get into it, Bill?
Yeah, we got a couple hot minutes. First one is Best Buy. Halo 4, as you know, went out last week. It's been the fall of cool games coming out, and depending on where that game is, depends on what maybe cool multiplayer skin you got, or maybe what extra missions you got. I did two at GameStop because my kids wanted that camo multiplayer skin, and I'm like, well, the Best Buy skin looks kind of cool. Plus, I think they had like a $20 gift card if I got it there, so I ordered one there. So now I'm stuck at midnight and with Sandy and the rain and the wind and stuff. I was like, you know, I better go out Monday night and get it at midnight.
Mm-hmm.
And that way, Tuesday, I'll have it first thing in the morning. I had to take my dog to a vet that night. And then plus it was election day. That's what it
That's
was.
That's right. It was election day. Yeah.
And then Wednesday was something else going on. I was like, you know what? I'm not going to have time to go out to all these stores over my lunch hour or do anything. So I'm going to go out midnight. Went to the mall, went to GameStop first, and they do everything so smooth. You walk in, you pay whatever's left on your pre-order if you still had anything remaining. So I had a couple dollars there, dropped that down, finished my two pre-orders on that, and they give you a receipt that shows you paid for these games. So at midnight, the strike of midnight, boom, You just walk over to the guy. He's got a big box of games. You show him your receipt. He hands you the games. You walk out of the store.
Exactly. I was out. That's the one thing about GameStop. They're cool on that, man.
They had it rolling because I was in my car. I mean, some people do events and the giveaway and a T-shirt. Dude, at midnight, if you're out there to get a game, you're out there to get the game because you want to play that as soon as possible. That's you don't right. really care about a T-shirt or whatever thing they got going on. You want to play the game as fast as possible. I was in my car with two games in my hand. At like 1 minute after midnight, I got there like 15 minutes before. I kind of milled around. And they said, "Boom, let's go start a line." And I just happened to be right like third in line.
Oh, cool!
So I was like, "Good, like, yeah, let's start the line right now." And so I drove. It was only maybe a couple blocks up. It was over near Golf Rat's house where the Best Buy is. Walk in there, and there's this huge line. There's maybe 100 people. And I'm like, oh, wait a minute, dude. It's after midnight. What's going on? I look. There's five registers going. Okay. They got registers going. Everything seems to be cool. Maybe they just started this going on. And I'm like, nobody's moving. No one's walking out past me with a video game in their hand. And
oh, wow.
And there's this goober walking around near the front of the store because the line stretched all the way out to the door.
Yeah.
And he's walking around with one of those inflatable helmets, you know, Halo helmets. Red versus blue, you know, one. I saw some guy in the store with a blue, and he is wearing red one. I'm like, dude, maybe you might want to go up there and check out why no one's walked past us with a game purchase yet, because it's been a few minutes after midnight, and no one's walked past me with a game.
Let me go check it out.
Oh, our registers are running slow.
Oh, goddamn, man.
Your registers are running slow. Don't you think you should have prepared
exactly.
for selling this game?
Dude, you had like to close. They closed like at 9.
Right.
You had 3 hours to straighten that shit out, man.
Yeah, you shouldn't even turn them registers off. I mean, you should have been ready to go. Dude, maybe take a hint from GameStop. Why don't you pre-ring everybody up? I'm sure you don't want to be here until the middle of the night. Dude, I waited in line, and had I known how long I was going to wait in line, I wouldn't have waited in line. But I didn't get out of there till like 7 minutes after 1.
I believe it, man.
In the morning.
That happened to me when I got Gears of War 3 yesterday, man. I had it. This was like 6 o'clock in that evening after work. I'm driving through traffic, man. I'm pumped up. I want to, you know, finish the trilogy off. I paid it for in full. I had to go to the customer service. Like, why do I have to go to the customer service? And I said it on the show before. The dude had to go back and check in the back. I'm like, bitch, why you gotta go check in the back?
Right.
Pay for it. Give me my damn games so I can go home and shoot some shit.
Right. I gotta go. You're wasting my time.
Dude, man, I'm like, I want to go home and shoot some shit, man. I need to. It took 20 minutes to get my game. And I knew if I win the GameStop, I'm going in and out like in 2 minutes.
Yep. And tell you what, that whatever that $20 coupon or whatever it was not worth staying in line for an hour.
Now what I did the next time was is like for Assassin's Creed Cree, I traded in some games and got like I traded in some games and got $60 on the gift card. So when that came out, I got the game and went straight to the line. Paid my $60 gift card and only cost me $5 to get Assassin's Creed 3. So that's the way I think you should do it because you're going to be in and out of there anyway.
Yeah. I mean, we complain about GameStop for, you know, a lot of different things, and rightfully so.
But one thing, man, if you want what you want to get in there, you be in and out. That's right.
If you want to play your game as fast as possible, go get it at GameStop. You'll be home. I could have been home at 11:45 playing that game.
Exactly.
Instead, I got home. It was like 1:30 in the morning. Of course, I'm going to put the game in now because I've been pissed off. I've been waiting forever for it. So I put it in. I played some of the campaign, and then I played a little bit of multiplayer just so I could have a taste of my reward for waiting.
For waiting in line.
You know? I ended up getting like 3 hours and 45 minutes of sleep that night. Now I had to go to work in the morning.
Exactly, man. I was dead. And
that's what
GameStop understands, man. It's like it's, you know, hey, man, these dudes want to go straight and play the game. But, hey, man, there's grown guys like us that just want to get the game and play a little bit and then go to bed, you know?
Right, I mean, right. I'm not staying up all night long, dude. I just
exactly,
need to play a little bit, man.
Exactly, man. Shoot. You know, you can't pull all night like some guys, like Rogue, shout out to Rogue Spear. His son finished the game like in 2 days.
Mm.
I don't know how he did that. And like they were saying something's wrong with him. And it was so funny, man, because you know he said he hasn't played it because his son's Xbox ain't working, so he had to borrow. His son is using his Xbox to play, so
He's not playing.
So he's complaining out. He hasn't.
Yeah, I know what that game is like. I know what that's
man,
like.
Oh, no. Oh, yep. Man.
Yeah, and I know a lot of people took off today because today is Black Ops 2 Day.
That's right.
Biggest pre-order sales, I think, ever of any game.
Not only that, man, like I was telling before the call, I saw like this launch show on Spike TV with Jeff Keighley and Justine Zizek, I think you pronounce her last name. She's iJustine on Twitter.
She's hotness.
Oh, man, she was wearing like this tight black leather dress. She was all about the black ops.
There you go.
She had like the tags on too, because you know it was pretty cool actually. Like the main guy from Treyarch was saying, you know, like, you know, proceeds go to like one of the programs for veterans. You know, if you buy the dog tags for like $5 if you want to buy the game too. So
right.
So it's just huge, man. They were at Australia, man. They were at England. They were in Toronto. They were in New York. They were all around the world, man. I mean, it's huge, man. And you know, I've been checking some of the reviews, man. It's enticing enough for me to kind of check it out, because shout outs to Toys R Us. I got like a sale. You buy a game for $60, you get $30 off the next game.
That's cool.
So, you know, I'm buying Halo 4 anyway. Right. You know, it's worth $30 to get.
Dude, that is a perfect combo right there. Halo last week and Black Ops today.
Yeah.
Black Ops arrived today and Amazon delivered it. And both my sons were playing. I'm like, all right, as soon as I get home, I'm gonna be playing it. So I'm just, one of you guys are gonna have to cough up a copy because I need to play it for the show. So it was like eating, meaning, mighty bow. Give me your extra.
Exactly.
Give me your extra.
You know, hey man, you're gonna have to give one up, man. Shoot.
But I gotta tell you, this is. I'm not good, no spoilers, but this is awesome. This is awesome. It's like a movie, the way it starts out. There are some gruesome scenes, so it's not for like a little kid to be playing this.
Yeah.
There is some stuff that I was like, wow, I can't believe they did that. Wow, I can't believe they showed that. Some of the graphics, I think, are a little not as cool as maybe the Halo or the Assassin's Creed. It's still good. It's not terrible, but.
They're talking about Halo 4 maybe the best on the 360 ever.
Yeah, it's hard when you got those two other games to compare it to that just came out. But it's a very good game. In fact, some of the voice acting looked. I was like, man, I recognize that actor's voice. And I'm like, oh my god, there's Oliver North. That you know, these are people, and it was just a great feel, a very professional feel. The things that they did in multiplayer, giving you these options to customize how you want to play it. Is amazing. They just did everything right. The fact that they give you the Elite, where you had to pay for it last year, they give it to you. They just give it to you now
for free. Yeah,
for free. So that's fantastic. And they give you an incentive now to perk up. If you go out and just read the review on IGN, it gives you a lot more detail than I'm going to go into now. Black Ops is the shit. I was not expecting. I thought it was just going to be a rehash, maybe just a new story, but no, it is not. They took some steps forward on this game.
And no, that's what they were saying, like, on the campaign. They said there was some, like, motion capture on the faces of the campaign on some of the characters. I'm like, motion capture? When the, you know, it's like a...
Yeah.
And I just think it's Treyarch, you know. They established this as, like, their third game, you know. So I think they got the engine down. They should have down by now, but you know,
I like Treyarch.
I think Treyarch has done a good job on their games versus where you had on last year's Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. You had like three different people, you know, messing around with it and all that. Yeah. And I had it. I got it on the cheap. I played the campaign once and I traded it in. I mean, so the story wasn't, you know. Actually, it was the worst story out of all of them. Even if I'm, you know, but I heard this campaign, you know, it's David Moyer, the guy that's behind Inception and Dark Knight Rises. You know, he helped with the story in it. You know, so if that tells you something right there, you know,
right.
That he said that they tried to make it to where, you know, they did an interview with him on the launch show, and they said that, you know, he tried to make it to where it's almost like a movie feel to it, the campaign.
It does. It feels like a movie. There's a lot of stuff there where there was like a rush of enemies near the beginning, and I'm like, it didn't seem like. I mean, I was I was shooting him, but I was also, and I was like, well, what if I don't shoot him? I wonder if I can just stand over here by this armored vehicle. And it didn't seem like it was making a difference whether I just unload clips into him or not. But then later when I had my targets that I had to take out to advance, that really mattered.
So, yeah, yeah.
But I dig it. I really, really, really like it. And it's I got a hard choice now because I got Assassin's Creed.
Yeah.
I got Halo.
Yeah.
And now I just started this. What do I play?
I'm going to have that decision on Friday, man, because you got to take advantage of, you know, these deals that are going on right now. You know, like they had a deal last week where, you know, Target, you buy one game, you get $40 off the next game, you know. No, it was buy two, get one free, like 2 weeks ago at Target.
Yeah, I think Assassin's Creed's going down a little cheaper too on Friday. Look for the Black Friday deals.
Yeah, yeah. I think at Best Buy it's $40 or something like that.
That's worth it, man.
It's worth it, absolutely.
That game is. In fact, we haven't talked about it because we talked about it since it seems like it's been forever.
No, man. Because the last time we were on, man, it was coming out that Tuesday.
Okay. So, yeah, because that's right. We recorded with Paris early that week.
Yeah, so, dude,
that's amazing. When you play that game and when you do that first level and then it gets to the spot where you get the title screen,
yeah,
where it just says Assassin's Creed 3, you're just like, hell yeah.
Yeah.
You know? It is exciting.
It opened awesome. I love the way it opened. It opened with that twist, and I was like, oh.
Yes,
so
yes.
Get into it a little bit. Right.
Right, that was awesome. Okay, let me go. I got two more hot minutes.
Yeah,
one's a real quick one because I know it's become routine. In fact, I saw Cthulhu80 tweet tonight that he jumped into multiplayer on Black Ops and felt like Ace Black and he hashtag cut down. and as funny as that is, at times truthful, it was not this weekend. Ace, we were in Blue, and a couple other guys, we were playing, actually Blue wasn't playing, he was in the party, but we were playing Halo 4 multiplayer. And on the top, I swear it was like four or five games in a row, top person in our party was Ace Black.
Oh, right.
Yes. He was laying it down, like 21-7. I mean, 21 kills, 7 dies. I mean, he was just. But you hear him. I didn't expect that kill to death ratio because he'd be shooting and he'd be talking shit like he does, and all of a sudden you hear him, "Help me! Help me! Help me!" and I wish I would have recorded it because it would have been perfect to play right now. But he is screaming, "Help me! Help me!" across the map. And then he's like, oh, okay, I got it. Later, he's on top of the list. He was not getting cut down. He was bringing it. And so, you know, props to Ace Black for breaking out of that cut down title.
All right. Need to call him Gun Down instead of Cut
Down. Gun Down. There you go.
He gunned him down. All right. Yep.
Okay, my other hot minute is cable TV. Oh, my God, you're killing me here.
Oh.
Right now, I know some people have, I guess, a choice between what cable company they go to. I'm out in the boonies. I'm out in the middle of the sticks. I got one cable company. And I guess a year ago, I got this one package where I got the phone, the internet, and the TV in one package. And I got, well, I wanted the high-def package. So I got the high def package, and then while I wanted the DVR, so I'm like, all right, so I got the DVR, and it was probably near the top of their list or whatever it is of the stuff that they offered. And that seemed to be pretty cool, and I think I added HBO just for a couple months when they ran a special because I needed it for Game of Thrones, but that ran out this week, and all of a sudden I got a bill that was prorated for a week, and my bill went up like $25. That was just prorated for the week, and I'm like,
whoa, hell?
My wife is freaking out. She's like, you know what? We're paying almost. We're looking at probably a $200 cable bill. I mean, that's like we could buy a car. You know?
Nah, man, shoot, that's like that's top of the line if you're paying that much a month.
Dude,
honestly,
$200 is bullshit. I don't know what I'm doing. And so I looked on their internet site, and I'm like, all right, well, I don't want this package here that I see. But it says it's like all the movies, Showtime, HBO, Encore, all that other stuff would still be less than they billed me for, you know, this last one. So I'm like, well, let me ask them about that. And they're like, well, I don't think you qualify for it because you already were in a package. You only qualify for that once. I'm like, nowhere on your website does it say anything about I only qualify that. She goes, it's like it's once and then you're done unless you upgrade. So I'm like, well, this is an upgrade, so I still qualify for it. So I got it for a year. I still I don't need all these HBO channels and Showtime channels and Encore channels and movie channels. I mean, I will watch HBO now that I have it, but
You don't need HBO West. You don't need HBO, you know, 2 West or
no,
Family or
Spanish.
Or you're not going to watch Boardwalk Empire or Game of Thrones in Spanish. You know, it's awesome that they have that, you know, but, you know, it's like you said, you know, it's like all these extra channels. You're not going to watch them.
Give me a la carte, man. If I could just keep these movie channels, give me an extra box or give me an increased internet speed and take something else.
I have UVerse, but and I just have HBO. I just pay $10 a month for HBO. That's it. Extra.
Okay.
Because I don't want all these other channels. You know, my wife loves True Blood, so, you know, I got to keep the wife happy. I'm getting True Blood. I'm only going to pay – no, it's $15 a month. $15 a month. But it's worth it to keep my wife happy, you know.
Yeah.
And HBO Go makes it worth it, too, because they show all the series from – way back when.
Right. So you can, there's a lot to choose from.
Yeah, you know, so that makes it worth it too. But for them not to say, oh, you can't have just HBO, that's just stupid.
Well, I was like, you know what, this might be my last year with this cable company. And they're like, well, you know, you could take some stuff off. I don't want to take any stuff off.
Why am I going to take stuff off and pay the same price for it? Or pay even more?
Right, pay even more. This is just dumb the way you work.
That's what I say. Are you insulting my intelligence right now? I mean, come on now. You know.
Oh, but it was horrible too. So I talked to this lady. And she's telling me at first I didn't qualify for anything. Then she's like, well, let me plug this in and see if you do qualify for that package. So I'm sitting there waiting. All of a sudden, there's just silence. Because I figure she's typing stuff in. All of a sudden, I go. She dropped the call.
Oh, hell no.
So I call again, and I have to go through the IVR, and I got to wait, and I got to talk to somebody in there. And she's like, okay, well, the lady you were talking to is still in your account. I can't actually go in there and do anything. And maybe I can make her call you back.
Oh, my God.
And this is during, there's you know, football on. It was on Saturday, and I was on the phone with them for probably like an hour and a half.
Oh, man.
Going back and
that's
forth.
That's messed up. See, because I'll tell you what. I called UVerse to switch Showtime to HBO. That shit took 10, 15 minutes. I said, I want to switch to HBO from Showtime. And there she was like, typed it. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
That's how it should be, man.
Right. Well, once I did say, yeah, I'll take that package, it by the time I got off the phone, I did have HBO. You know, so, but man, this is not good. I don't know what I'm going to do. That's too much money a month to wrap my head around.
That is too much money a month. But speaking of cable, you're not the only one that's pissed off at cable companies. As we segue into the best and worst of the week, the worst thing is, I don't know if I need to blame Comcast Sportsnet. This is a channel that has an exclusive deal to show Houston Rockets and Houston Astros games. If you don't have this channel, you can't watch any of their games.
None of them.
We're talking everybody. We're talking people at home. We're talking people at sports bars. Everybody. Me and my friend, we were at a Buffalo Wild Wing last Thursday night, right after work, and we asked the lady, like, do you show Rockets? She's like, no, because we don't have that channel. And I didn't know. I thought it was just Rockets games, but she said they don't show Astros games either. So she said at that Buffalo Wild Wing, they can't show Rockets games because they don't have this channel, this Comcast channel.
That's not right.
No. And
that's not right at all.
Like, what the hell? It's like, okay, my friend watched the Rockets games because he has Comcast. So it automatically comes to that channel. And we have the choice. You know, you got DirecTV. I have UVerse. See, my brother-in-law, he's a huge Houston Rockets fan. In fact, they interviewed him at a local station here about this shit.
Wow.
That's how upset fans are, right? Okay, so it's like, first off, if you are the Houston Rockets and the Houston Astros, I don't blame the Astros because they suck and they're trying to get anything. I don't blame the Astros. But if you're the Houston Rockets, this is the slogan, a new age, right? We just traded for James Harden, the beard. We got Lin Sanity, Jeremy Lin from New York. We got all these different players, you know. There's no way I'm going to go to a Rockets game and pay all that money for tickets if I'm not watching how the team is doing on TV. That's right. Anybody.
Right? Right, you're losing your fan base then.
I think it's worse. I'm a Spurs fan first and a Rockets fan second. It's like 1-1A. But when they did this shit, it's making me not want to be a Rockets fan anymore. Because It's like, okay. Like last night, they played the Miami Heat, the world champion, the defending world champions last night. And from what I saw, it was 113-110. It's like everybody in the city would have watched that game. Bars are losing money, but see, I don't blame these bars for not switching cable companies just to watch Houston Rockets games.
Right, just to watch the game. I saw something on the news, too, about, wasn't it the Texas Longhorns or something?
They got their own channel.
Right, they got their own channel. And wasn't their coach bitching about that? He's thinking that's hurting their team.
It is hurting them because not everybody has that fucking channel. You got to order that.
Right.
But you know what? The lady said the same thing about that, too. She said, we can't show Texas Longhorns games because they have their own channel.
Yeah, that's stupid.
If they're not on nationwide TV, you can't see them.
Right. Penn State did that, or the Big Ten. There's a Big Ten channel. Network. Yeah.
But you know what? I have that on,
I don't have Big
Ten. U-verse. That's on U-verse. Is it? And the package that I have.
I don't have it. I don't know anybody has it. So, it's weird, though. That only affects maybe one or two games out of, at least exactly. So far this year, that I wasn't able to watch.
Even though all the stuff happened in Penn State, they still show them on ESPN, pretty much.
Right. They still show them on ESPN. They still show them on the ABC.
Because the Rockets just, traded for James Harden. They're not on a national TV schedule like that. So you had to depend on watching them locally.
See, that's wrong. With the trouble you're having with cable and trouble I'm having with cable, something's going to come to a head. They are going to have to be a big shift in the way people select.
And so they're full of themselves, Bill. I mean, they're like, go to ICSN, iwantcnhouston.com and tell your cable provider to add Comcast Sportsnet Houston. It's like, dude, they're not going to do that shit. Why are they going to even do that? It's like, and I've actually saw some fans say, I'm going to drop U-verse because they're not showing Rockets games. It's like, you stupid ass, go ahead and do that shit. I love U-verse, man. I can record, I can watch recorded shows on any receiver in my house. I can tape like two or three shows at the same time. Man, it saves me on these last Sunday nights when my wife wants to watch Real Housewives of Atlanta at 8 o'clock. I got to make sure Walking Dead is taped and Boardwalk Empire is taped because after that, she's going to watch that. I can do that.
That's cool.
But ain't no way in hell I'm watching you dropping U-verse because of the damn Rockets. I am content of not seeing the beard or the insanity all year long. It's just dumb. I don't.
Yeah, it is dumb. And technology is moving so fast that they'll find a way around that.
Exactly, man. Honestly, the way around it, if you really want to watch it, is to pay for the NBA League Pass. But you know what? Why are you going to pay like $170 just to watch Rocket games?
Just to watch local games.
My brother-in-law asked me that, and I told him, I was like, dude, why would you do that? Why would you pay $170 just to check out Rocket games? It's like, it doesn't make any sense, man. He's like, you know what, TJ, you're right, man. I can't afford to do that. Nobody can afford to do that. Unless you're a true basketball fan, and honestly, you really don't need to because they actually show the best teams on ESPN or on TNT Tuesday, Thursday, Friday nights.
Right.
And after Christmas, they're going to show them like almost every day. So it's just, I don't understand the management of the Rockets. I don't understand actually how David Stern lets them get away with shit like this. I'm wondering if it's happening, across America like that. But you know what? Fuck cable companies right now. It's just frustrating, man.
It is frustrating. Well, what good happened to you this week?
What good happened to me, man, is I watched the Forward On to Dawn live series. And you know what, man? That was excellently done. It was so excellently done. It makes me want to get Halo 4. After watching it,
I tell you what. Honestly, I only saw parts of it. I didn't watch.
Oh,
I didn't watch it. Man. I heard good things. Well, last podcast we talked a little bit about too.
Yeah, the last podcast we had, they were up to three or four, but they had the fifth one, and the fifth one, Chief comes in. This one just throws it down, man. But it's just excellently done. you know, and I watched the whole thing. They actually have it where you can watch it as like a film, the whole thing, nonstop. It's even cooler watching it that way.
Good.
You know, so that's my best. So let's get to your best and worst.
Well, my best rolls right into that. Is Halo 4.
Right.
Dude, I've been waiting for this game. And I tell you what, 343 has my love, because I thought it was all about Bungie this, Bungie that. But you know what? No. 343 has knocked them out of the picture, knocked this one out of the park. The beautiful scenery that they've created, the colors, the CGI, everything looks fantastic on this game. And I don't know if I could be happier. Now, there's some weird stuff with the campaign. I'm not giving secrets away, but as I'm playing it, I'm like, whoa, what's going on here? Maybe it's just me not being up on the lore. Now, I'm going to have to go back and listen to all the Henry Knox Halo podcasts and get deep into that canon of it.
I have listened to them, but you know what? Shout out to Scarfinger on his 200th episode of Scarcasm Live. He said that he played through the campaign already. And he says, basically, if you haven't read the book called Halo Glasslands, you're not going to really know what's going on with the campaigns.
Yeah, there's some stuff that's like, I'm like, wait a minute, who's this?
He said during the game, you don't notice it. But he said, you don't know what the hell's going on unless you read that book. So that's something that I've listened to all the perspective. Shout out to Henry Knox and everybody that did that. It was awesome. I feel like I'm caught up with it somewhat.
Cool.
You know, listening to those. But he feels your pain on that, because he actually said that.
Well, I had someone at work ask me, hey, you know, they didn't play any Halo previously.
Uh-huh.
Just maybe a couple minutes of the first one. They're like, you know, should I go out and pick up Halo 4? I'm like, wow, I don't even know how you'd even do that. I mean, if instinct, I want to tell you, yes, go play Halo 4, because it is that good, you know, of a game.
Well, what was cool about it?
But why would you start?
It's a new trilogy. That's the one good thing about it.
I mean, would you start watching Star Wars, you know, in the middle of it? I mean, I guess that's where they gave it to us. But now if you had
That's like starting, you know, on episode one. No.
Yeah, it's like, oh, Boardwalk Empire is pretty cool. Let me just start with, season three.
Yeah.
No, that doesn't make any sense. Why would you not go back and know what's going on? Because a lot of the cool stuff that's happened, just the little stuff between him and Cortana, you wouldn't really get unless you knew their relationship from 1, 2, 3, you know, I mean, it is a beautiful game, and we had a lot of fun playing multiplayer. The campaign looks great. So that was my best of the week, maybe up until I played Black Ops.
Exactly, man. One thing they said, Morgan Webb said this on the review, like, the sexual tension between Cortana and Master Chief, for real?
Kind of. They drew her really well.
No, I heard that they drew her very well. Like,
yeah.
Like, a shout out to Glovebox on the 40Cast. They said she upgraded, like, awesome upgrade.
Yeah, she did some awesome upgrades. And there is a relationship between her and Chief that she's been with him so long.
Yeah.
I don't know if you would, because sexual tension, or if it's just that interpersonal relationship you have with someone that you've been through a lot of stuff with.
A lot of stuff.
And you know, I'm sorry I snapped at you, or, you know, like, you know, it's just the jealousy of, you know, I mean, that's the attention. They have that one-on-one. She's in his brain, you know, when he puts the chicken back. So, yeah, there is something there between them, obviously.
It's through the first game, you know, listen to the perspectives, you know, like the stuff they went through the first game, you know, on to the second and on to the third. You know, I mean, they've been through a lot of shit together. So
I got to tell you what, this game is amazing. I have Assassin's Creed 3.
Yeah.
I started playing that, and I just started playing as Connor. Things are going real well.
Mm-hmm.
And then Halo came out, and I was like, oh, my God, I'm all about this game. I'll be playing Assassin's Creed later, because now
I'm really, man,
all about this beautiful game. And they did, you know, so many things well. They, you know, the grunts used to be so easy to wipe out. You know, those little guys. Now they're harder. If they turn their back on you, you know, you have to unload on them because they got that armor, you know, little thing that they carry on. But if they're in their face, you get, you know, they're easier to hit. Just little things. But you're it seems to be searching for ammo all the time.
Mm-hmm.
But I really dig it. I like the new weapons. I like some of the new characters. Even some of the stuff I'm not following so well. I'm just, you know what? I'm going. I'm along for the ride. Take me. It's beautiful. I like it.
I mean, so, I heard it's awesome. I can't wait to play it. I feel like I'm ready. Because I haven't played a Halo game. I'm one of those guys that haven't played any.
Oh, haven't you?
Not at all, you know, but I'm like, well, I'm not going to buy Reach and play it. I'm not going to play OST. Going to go to the route of playing Halo 4 first, and then, because I think I saw, like, at Walmart, Halo Reach is like $10.
Yeah, it's pretty sure. I just traded one in. I think we talked about like two.
Yeah. So it's like,
I got some good money on it. But yeah, you can get them cheap now. But Halo 2, I think, was one of the best. I had a lot of fun playing that one. Just mm-hmm. memories. The first one they redid, so I wouldn't even go back and play the first one. I do the Combat Evolved. I'd do the Anniversary Edition where they upgraded the graphics. It's still the same game.
Yeah, because 343 touched that one. Basically.
Yeah, it's still the same game. They didn't really change any of the code. They just updated some of the graphics. I would play that one in 2, 3, I guess maybe just for the storyline.
Well, see, that's the thing. I kind of feel like I'm caught up on the storyline somewhat.
Oh, yeah.
I've gone back to, like, even on YouTube, there's some things where they actually break down, like, what happened, you know, between
mm-hmm.
between 1. And actually, I know how it goes Halo, you know, because of the perspectives. Thanks to Knox, you know, it goes Halo Wars, then it goes Reach, then it goes 1, 2, 3,
right.
ODST. So I kind of have somewhat, I'm not into it like everybody else. You know, I know enough to where, like, you know, I'm ready to play 4. I'm going to get into 4. I'm ready to get into
4. Jump in, man.
I'm ready to jump in, man. Exactly, man. Shoot.
We will have some fun.
You know, and then watching the Forward on the Dawn, man, that makes me want to even be Chief even more, man. Like, that's a badass motherfucker, man.
He is. Oh, dude, when I see Master Chief in this game for the first time, I was like, the hair is standing up on my arms. I was like, oh, my gosh, Master Chief.
It was
like a Star Wars movie, you know, going to see. It was just that exciting.
And you know what? They did a good job on that film, bringing that out of the game into live action.
Yeah,
they did.
I would love to see a live action movie.
If you
pick up Halo 4, anybody listening to this haven't, go out and get it and join us for some multiplayer, and we will follow Ace Black into battle and have
That's
him
right.
lead us.
That's right. Yeah,
gun down the enemy. But you have to just put up with him going, help me. He don't need any help. He's gunning them down.
That's right. That's right.
Oh, okay. And my worst of the week would be, driving my kids around. They're in the marching band at the high school. They're in middle school, but they're still playing with the high school band. Oh. And we had a football game Friday night. I had to go down to the school. I had to go down to school on Saturday. Was it Friday? Saturday? Anyway, I had a parent-teacher thing. We had to go in there, and the kids are doing good. Everything's great. Come back. And that was on Friday. Then we did the football game. Saturday, my son's in the National Junior Honor Society thing. They had a pancake breakfast or something that he had to go help with. So I didn't know about it. So I'm sitting laying in bed 6:30 Saturday morning, laying there in bed with my wife, and the phone's ringing. Because his friend needs a ride down there. I'm like, to the school. You didn't tell me about this.
What?
So I got to jump out of bed, drive him down there, get him down to the school by 7. Then I had to go back and pick him up and take him so he could go. Where the hell did he have to go? Get ready for a parade. And then we had a Veterans Day parade, which is good.
Yeah.
You know, shout out to veterans. Thank you very much. It was a great parade. Then I had to take them back to the school, wait for them to do. Dude, I had, just between that morning, I had been up and down that road 4 times. And just, I'm out in the country, and it's a long distance.
Oh, yeah.
And I was tired of driving around. And so my oldest son's 14. Now I'm, you know, and I want to push him to 16 and start driving, but
it would be a whole lot easier. Yeah, it'd be a whole lot easier.
So, like, on my Saturday, it was spent driving up and down the road. I was like, you know, I was hoping to get a Saturday morning where I could play some Halo and, you know, ease into some football, but no. None of that happened.
Yeah.
So that sucked.
Oh, man. That sucks. But what does not suck is, like Vi says, if you want to get into the game nights, please hit us up. We are at week 10 of OFR NCAA 13 Dynasty. And I think everybody's played their game, but you, Vlad, you mentioned that you played. But I understand, man. I understand. There's a lot of stuff out there right now, but everybody in our dynasty is keeping up, man. I'll get like email updates saying that somebody finished their game here and there, and it's getting to the nitty gritty, man. It's getting the bowl season, man. It's kind of cool because it's kind of like chronologically correct, even though we started way back when.
Right.
Getting to the nitty gritty in real college football too. So,
dude, I was so pissed off. I was playing Ohio State as Penn State, and with just seconds to go in the game, I had a guy wide open, and if I would hit my Y receiver, I would have had a touchdown, won the game with like 7 seconds left.
Oh, man.
But as I went to hit the Y, my thumb kind of rolled off, and I hit the B receiver, who was covered. So I did not get the touchdown, and we went into overtime. And blew it in overtime.
Oh, man.
I was just pissed off. I was like, you know what?
I'm getting those breaks myself, man. Like, you know, like one game, it was tough, man. Like one game I won only because I intercepted the ball for return for the touchdown, like late in the game. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm TCU. I'm the TCU Horned Frogs, and I'm ranked number 2 in the country right now, man. So if I win the next game, but I got that game and the beat in the Big 12 championship game. And I'm kind of scared, man, because, like, shit, man. If I lose it, that's pretty much it, man. So hopefully I win the next game and I'm in the championship. But everybody's like right there, man. Like Ace of Florida, he's like number 3, and I think shout outs to Nemesis Prime, he's number 4, number 5, and then Bedside PhD is like number 5 with Boise State. It's like we're all in the top 10.
That's cool.
So it's gonna be like some BCS games and all that stuff. So it's cool, man.
All right. Well, I apologize to all those guys. I'm gonna try and wrap that up. So this weekend, then we could start. Actually, yeah, it is like a chronological order.
It is, man. So
play the game for this weekend.
But like I said, man, everybody's playing. You know. Like,
yeah, everybody's got their hands.
Like this Friday. This Friday, I plan to be on Halo. On there with Halo 4 and Black Ops. I don't know which one, but I'm be playing both of them. So
just bounce back and forth.
Look us for us on the game nights on Fridays and Saturdays, man. So that's cool. So now we're gonna get into our top 3, the best things we saw, heard, or played. And Vlad, we talked about pretty much all. Well, we didn't talk about Assassin's Creed 3, but we pretty much talked about Halo 4.
Yeah. There's a lot that was good this week.
Oh yeah.
Even the last 2 weeks since we talked, but and I could talk about how Walking Dead is just freaking awesome.
Oh, wow. Oh.
And I could talk about how American Horror Story has got every single freaky thing in it. It's got possessions and ghosts and aliens and mental illness and
Nazis. That's the one I need to get into.
Mutations and sexual situations.
Oh,
and serial killers. You name the weird thing, and it's got it in it.
Oh, right.
I could talk about all that.
I need to catch up on that one.
Yeah. But what I'm going to talk about is the top 3 things. Assassin's Creed 3. Beautiful. I love it.
Oh, yeah.
Halo 4, fantastic. Visually amazing. Black Ops 2, surprise, awesome. I will be playing this game for a while.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Well, that's on my top. I only got Assassin's Creed 3, but that's enough right now until I get Halo 4 and Black Ops 2. But I am loving the way they did the story of Connor and what happened to him early and how it ties in into all the historical figures that I've seen so far, from Samuel Adams to Charles Lee to Benjamin Franklin, you know, I don't think that's a spoiler because they talked about how you're going to see historical figures like that anyway. But there is a twist early that I'm not going to give up, you know, and it kind of sets the whole game after that, which is very cool. So, I'm enjoying that game. You know, a lot of people talk about how they are more prone to do the not to do the side stuff and stick to the story. I'll tell you one situation that happened. Like, I'm minding my own business, walking in the plains, right? I'm going through trees. I see a wagon burning. So I'm like, oh, what the hell's going on over there? Okay, so I walk over there, right? These dudes throw a guy off the cliff.
Oh my god.
I'm dead serious. I'm looking, you know, and they're like, ah. And so they look at me in turn, and they try to kick my ass. Because the thing comes up and says, oh, they're robbing this wagon and robbing this guy. They walked in on it. They can't leave any witnesses. So, dude, man, I got killed, man, because honestly, I wasn't really prepared for it. I was just walking over there. I was just walking over there, seeing what the hell's going on.
Right.
And they killed my ass.
Damn.
And that was just one situation, random, you know, that happened, you know? I mean, all kind of shit like that happens, man. Like, I'll walk through Boston, right? And, dude, you know, you get in the way of one of the guards, they'll push you out of the way. I mean, they'll literally push you out of the way. So I made the mistake of hitting the dude, right? Man, I got jumped by like 10 guards, and I'm in a fight with 10 guards. But I killed all of them. I killed all 10.
Yep.
And looted all 10.
Yep. That is awesome. I love hanging out in Boston.
I can tell you what, my kid was telling me, he's like, hey, my friend at school, he's bringing his Xbox into school tomorrow. I'm like, in Assassin's Creed 3. I'm like, what are you doing? He's like, well, we're talking about Bunker Hill, and he's going to plug in his Xbox to the overhead thing and throw it up on the screen. And his teacher said he could bring it in. They were going to talk about the Battle of Bunker Hill, and he was going to show him where Bunker Hill is in relation to how the town may have looked back then. I was like, that's the shit. You get to play Xbox in school.
I remember, awesome. I remember I did that a long time ago at ITT, man. I did a report on violence in games. I did a report. And this is when Mortal Kombat came out on the Sega Genesis.
Okay, that was back then.
Way back then, man. I did like the Scorpion thing, you know, where he basically takes the head off with the spine hanging.
Mm-hmm.
I shot the whole class and got an A on that report.
That's so cool.
It's so cool that you can use that sometimes, man. You know, so that is awesome. And it is like historically it's they do a good job with that to a T. Yeah. But I think on this one, they've done the best so far. I think
they did really good. I didn't get too far into it. I got into Boston and I'm having fun. I had that 10-minute conversation with Ben Franklin about chicks.
Oh yeah, man.
That was great. That was great.
That was funny. And one cool thing is, too, you know, it may seem kind of far. Oh, and the naval battles are awesome, too.
That was good.
Those are awesome. I love that. But you can, if you really want to stick to the story, they really let you stick to the story. But because you can fast travel to certain spots if you want to. You know, like, say, do you want to fast travel here? And then you're like, because, you know, you can see where your next mission needs to go. Like, because sometimes you need to, your mission is in Boston, but then and the next one is like way, you know, in the country where basically, you know, what's his name? Achilles is, you know, the guy that, you know, I don't want to spoil it if anybody hasn't played it.
Right, yeah.
But it's an awesome game. You should pick that up. Please pick it up.
Yeah, absolutely. It's fun.
But that's one of my top three. But also, man, Boardwalk Empire is getting gangsta. It's getting raw. It is. Oh, man. There's three episodes left in the season, man. And best season so far. Like, it is just Steve Buscemi is he should win. He won a Golden Globe on the first season.
Mm-hmm.
He should win an Emmy for this, the job he's doing on the show right now.
Yeah, I dig him as an actor. I think he's really cool.
But it's not just him. It's this character called Jip Rossetti, man. Oh, my. This dude is ruthless, man. He's like Scarface times six. He does not give a damn.
Really?
Oh, man. He does not care, man. I mean, this dude is beating up police. He anything that he feels like he needs to do to go on top, he's going to do. So it's just coming to a head right now, and there's three seasons left. But not only the stuff going on with, you know, with Nucky Thompson and the other guys, you know, and, you know, the bootlegging business, but there's a side thing with, you know, with Margaret also.
Mm-hmm.
That, you know, that's actually very interesting, too, that happened this week, you know, so that's awesome. And,
yeah, it looks like a great shot.
Yeah. And I rented a movie called The Cabin in the Woods, and
woo,
very, very cool movie, man.
Wasn't that awesome?
Oh, wow. Oh, man.
Dude, that was a great show.
You know what? I am so happy people thought enough of this movie not to spoil it at all. Like,
right. Anybody I talked to was like,
nobody
wants to
tell you
anything about it.
Nothing about it. So it was cool going in knowing nothing. And, man, the last 15 minutes of this movie is just awesome. The whole movie is good, but the last 15 minutes.
They bring it on.
Oh,
yes,
man. It's crazy.
That shit in the hallway.
Oh my God. When that ding comes off and that dude says, holy shit. I swear to God, Bill, I rewinded that thing like 10 times because there's so much going on. In that one little area, in that one little scene, I had to see it all. I had to see. I went to like each one and saw which one was what was doing what. I mean,
right. That was an amazing,
awesome movie, man. If this is cheap on Black Friday, I'm gonna pick it.
Just go pick it up.
I'm gonna pick it up, man. I'm gonna pick it up, man. Because it, I think my wife will love it, man. I think, you know, she's. I mean, it's not horror per se, you know. It's not really horror, really. It's kind of like a mix between horror and mystery almost, really.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because it's kind of like, okay, you know, horror and the fact that, yeah, there's some gruesome stuff going on. But the story of and the background of what's actually happening makes it kind of mystery because you don't know. You know, you don't know, like, where they're going with it. Like, okay, why are they doing what they are doing? You don't know until, like, the end of the movie, you don't know.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Awesome movie. Awesome movie. Check that out. You know, it should be on demand. I got it on demand. You know, check out Amazon, all that. All your outlets that you rent from. Check it out. So now we're going to get into sports. And you need to update me on Michael Vick, man, because I didn't know he was hurt this bad.
Dude, yeah, right early in the game, he got hit.
I know he got hit, knocked out of the game, but
he got hit pretty hard, and then he stayed in for another play, and then he got hit, knocked down again. And at first they thought, well, maybe his helmet hit his eye because he came off, and I was like, dude, I don't know. He came off his eyelids, you know, like you look at a guy who's been drinking, his eyelids are halfway down his eye. That's the way he came off the field. I was like, dude, that guy is not knowing where the hell he's at. And they came and sat him down. They talked to him. Apparently, he's got a severe concussion.
Ooh,
and they said that he may need rested for the remainder of the season.
I think he's going to be resting for the rest of the season.
And I think the reason, well, I think maybe it's the severity of the concussion. Those are serious things. I mean, your brain gets rattled and sloshed around.
Man.
It does take some time to come back from
exactly.
That.
Until he's cleared, which is going to probably be like 3 weeks, you know, just to recover from the concussion.
I mean, they're real quick about putting players back in. All they had a concussion halfway through the game. He's back in.
They're not playing with it.
Even with hockey, like Jaromir Jagr, he was out for, a year?
Yeah.
For a concussion.
Oh, yeah.
They can be pretty bad. And I think maybe part of it might be that it was pretty bad. Might be part of it that Andy Reid's trying to salvage his career, you know, because going, you know, we are sucking really bad. And maybe if I try this new guy, this rookie that
we got. Well, you know what? Everybody wants him to play anyway, so this is a good excuse for him to do it.
Right. And why switch players when they're doing well, you know?
It does save his job because, honestly, I think they needed to win that game on Sunday to save his job. Like, honestly, they were playing for their jobs. Jason Garrett and Andy Reid were playing for their jobs in that game. Yep. And I think Jason Garrett is safe. I don't think Andy Reid is safe.
At least for another week.
No, I think if some miracle where they don't make the playoffs happens, I think he's gone. He's done, man. because that's just too much talent. I mean,
talent
on the offensive side. The defense is not the same as it has been before, but,
You look at the Eagles, and on paper, they should be winning.
No. It's the same thing with the Cowboys, like, on paper.
And the Cowboys, too. On paper, they should be on top.
Exactly.
But then when you get into the game and you have false start.
Yeah.
Hands to the face, false start. I mean, constantly.
And I can tell you what, I do not blame Romo at all. What's going on? He's playing. Actually, I say Romo's playing good.
I think he's playing well. His offensive line really has sucked.
They sucked.
Has sucked. And the false starts and those penalties.
He did one move in that game where he avoided three or four sacks in the same. On the same play.
Same play.
And passed it for like 25 yards. And that was awesome.
Yeah.
I was like, damn. He's the only one that honestly can do shit like that, honestly.
Yeah. I'm not down on the Cowboys. I mean, I'm a big Cowboys fan.
They still got a shot. I mean, they still got a shot. I mean,
they still have a shot. As long as the Giants keep losing, the Cowboys keep winning.
And you know what? Wow. My friend, he dropped Eli like 2 weeks ago with his fantasy team. And then another one that, because that's all we talk about at work, man, is fantasy football. Because we got like one league at work, and then the other guys do other leagues, with their friends and all that. Mm-hmm. Another guy, who sits in front of me, he's like, I'm driving Akeem Nicks, man. He sucks. He's been hurt all year, man. He's like, but my friend, man, unfortunately, he had Eli and both leagues, the one at work and the one that he's in with my friends, he has Eli. He dropped him in both of them.
Wow.
He's like, whoa. He's like, dude, Eli's just been sucking. And they don't look good. Like, they got destroyed by the Bengals.
Yeah, they did. Destroyed by the Bengals.
They got destroyed. I mean, the score, they should have got whooped more. They lost like
21
to 6, but they should have got whooped more the way it was looking.
Right, it should have been more like that Ravens victory over the Raiders.
Exactly.
55 over 20. And you see that. They showed a clip there where the Ravens went and got their last touchdown, and the coach looked like I shouldn't have done that. I should have just kicked the field goal.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry. He felt bad for beating them that bad.
But it's weird. You need to practice.
Healthy teams are doing well, and teams that – are not healthy, are struggling. Yeah. And logic, but Roethlisberger, he got hurt, separated his shoulder, and they struggled against the Chiefs. They should have beat the Chiefs.
Roethlisberger has a separated shoulder. He may be gone for like 3 or 4 games.
Right. They are not good without it.
Oh, man. Alex Smith, for the 49ers, he got a concussion. He got knocked out.
He got a concussion. I heard, and I saw a headline on Yahoo that he threw that last touchdown pass with blurred vision. He just threw it.
Jay Cutler got knocked out of a concussion, too, on the Sunday night game.
Yeah.
So it's like, so that's like four good quarterbacks. I mean,
you know what happens? That the next year in the draft, people are going, we need to protect our quarterbacks. We need to start drafting offensive line.
I blame the management there has to be somebody better out there than Byron Leftwich. I'm sorry.
Exactly. Why were you letting that guy sit in your team?
Somebody young. I mean, yeah, he's experienced, but
he's an experienced veteran.
But that man, you draft a young guy and you let him learn from the older guy.
Yeah. At some point, the Steelers are going to have to go, all right, who's going to be the replacement
This isn't the first time Big Ben got hurt.
Last year he was a cripple.
He
couldn't walk. This was bad. His nose, his eye, his arm, his knee, his ankle.
That's what the 49ers did. They got Colin Kaepernick. They got that young guy who runs, and all that, and he's involved with the offense somewhat. So so they did good on there.
I'm not writing Ben off. I mean, I would love to have Ben on my team, but
me too.
But at some point you got to start looking, and I'm looking at like Romo too. I'm like, all right, he's been out there for a while. You need to have a serious backup quarterback. You can't have these. I wasn't real happy, last year when you have like the veterans sitting as your backup quarterback who may come in and be able to take the snap or two, but it's not a solution long term.
Exactly, man. And the Texans, just for an example, they won a playoff game with their rookie backup, last year. I mean, so, and he's the backup now. I mean, so you know, it's I think you need to, it depends on your system, but, you know, the way Ben plays, the way that he extends the play with his feet and all that, you got to know that, okay, I can't, if Big Ben is moving his feet to avoid sacks, Byron Leftwich is not going to avoid sacks. He's not going to move his feet. You got to know your personnel. You got to know what you're doing on offense, too. I mean, so yeah. You can't blame nothing but management on that one. But going into the Falcons, there's no more undefeated. Yes, 72 Dolphins, bring up the champagne, all that bullshit. Like,
I know. You know what?
See, this is the Falcons, man. I
want someone to beat them just because
of
that bullshit.
I ain't going to lie, man. Like,
I want to see them
Nick Bonacani can kiss a lot of asses, man, because that was like, it's like you get mad because somebody is going to do something that you did, like, in 1972. You know, it's like, and plus, that was 14 games. There's more games played.
Yep. The Patriots did it in 16 games.
Dude, you Patriots know? Almost Which did was... it. Patriots almost did it.
Right, right.
They were shitting their pants, man, when that shit happened, man.
Oh, you know. Oh, you know, they were celebrating.
You know what? I wish they did it. It's like, man, I saw one year, man, and Nick Bonacani is like raising his glasses with the other Dolphin players. He's like, what the fuck, man? It's like, why are you holding on to shit like that? It's like, come on, man. The most important thing that you did was win the Super Bowl that year. That was the most important thing out of that. It's like, why are you going to be envious for other teams that are going to do something that's historic? It's like, man, that's bullshit, man.
Yeah, it's bullshit.
But man, Saints are hot right now.
Yeah. Oh, and did you happen to experience the Sunday's fantasy football craziness with? I went to go update one of my rosters, move my tight end, and I thought I was like, wow, my Facebook's, you know, my Yahoo fantasy football screen's not coming up.
You know,
let me try it again.
Unfortunately, I'm not on Yahoo this year. So.
Oh, good Lord. And it finally came up, and I'm like, okay, well, let me change my tight end.
And you could. And
hit save. And then I'm like, the screen went blank again. I'm like, what's going on? It was down all day.
Oh, that's...
And then finally, in the evening when it came up, it didn't take my save.
Oh, that sucks.
I would have lost anyway. But so that really, really didn't matter in the end. But it was just the fact that it went down at noon on football day.
You know what? That's why the guy that does our league at work, he did Yahoo last year, but we had some problems, so he decided to do NFL.com. And we haven't had any problems on NFL.com. So I just don't like the scoring on NFL.com. Like, I don't like the leagues where they minus you on the interceptions.
Yeah.
And defense doesn't score as much points as in other leagues that I do. You know?
I got 0 points in my defense, and sometimes
how does that happen? It's like, you know, there was a sack, there's an interception, there's a forced fumble, there's something.
Right.
I mean, it's like, what the hell's going on? You know, like him,
and it, you can set it up differently, I guess, your commissioner.
You can, that. Like, because in my league, I've been with my friends for like 6 or 7 years, we kind of do like it's kind of like a standard scoring, but it's like a reward yardage standard scoring, like it's double points for a quarterback score, you know, running in a touchdown.
Right.
Like instead of 6, you get 12.
Okay. Well, that's cool.
Oh, yeah, you know, and let's say, you know, like, let's say Dez Bryant, you know, he runs for a, you know, if he runs for like a 77-yard touchdown, 41 yards or more, that's 12 points. So he would have gotten 12 points just for scoring a touchdown, wow, plus the yardage. So it went 7 points for the yardage and 12 points for the touchdown. So your players get rewarded for big plays. That's basically what it is.
All right.
You know? Cool. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like, dude, I started out so great at fantasy football this year, and then I just have lost like 5 straight. It's horrible. Not by much, but each one I've started the wrong.
I'm breaking even on both of them, man. It's kind of weird. Like in one league, I was 4-0, but then I lost 3 straight. But now I'm 6-4 in that one. But on the one at work, I was 1-4, but now I'm 5-5 in that one. I won 4 straight in that one. And you know what? It's because of Doug Martin. Doug Martin
is a beast.
And Peyton Manning. Oh my God, Peyton Manning is killing it right now, man. Oh man, he's killing it. Oh
yes, man. He is. Yes.
You know, like that last week, you know how Doug Martin had that big game against the Raiders? You know, I got I got 52 points.
Just for him.
But in the league that I'm in where they reward you for, like, big plays, my friend that had him had, like, 70 points because of him. just for him.
Hey, let me ask you, do you watch any NASCAR at all?
No, but I watched that fight go down.
Dude, how about yeah, that was almost like football.
That shit was nuts. You know what? I looked at it on Twitter because, you know, one of my followers said, did anybody see the fight that went down at the race? I'm like, fight! So I turned on ESPN right then, and right when I turned it on, they showed exactly what went down, man. Dude. And you know what? I do not blame that guy that won cursing like that. Like, maybe he shouldn't have cursed like that, but I can understand what he's coming from, man.
Yeah,
he could have. They could have hurt a lot more people.
At some point, when you're driving at nearly 200 miles an hour and you purposely wreck into somebody, that almost doesn't become to a point where it's part of the game anymore. That's almost like, you know,
and he's like,
manslaughter. You know, because like, you were going to kill somebody.
Interviewed Jeff Gordon, he's like, I was just frustrated. I got tired of it. Like, dude. Yes.
I want to take him out. I did it on purpose.
You could have killed somebody doing that shit, man.
And yeah, you're not talking like maybe, oh, I hit him a little too high on the football field, or I threw the ball a little inside, maybe caught him on the chin, you know, with baseball. But, dude, when you're driving a car, that's a couple thousand pounds at 200-some miles an hour, and you do something stupid like try and wreck somebody?
Dude, what if he ran into him and that dude in another car, they wrecked into the damn wall, blow up?
Right. Because it wasn't just him. He took out other cars, too.
Two other cars.
One of those guys would have died. Holy crap. I mean, because people have died out there before.
Nah, man. Dale Earnhardt died doing that.
And it seemed like a little small little collision that, boom, snapped his neck.
Right into the wall.
Yep.
And it's like, but to purposely do that, because, you know, he bumped me. Okay. Mm-hmm. I thought that was part of the whole thing. You know, you're going to have bumps here and there.
Yeah. And I know that NASCAR's last couple of years have been letting people get away with that a little bit more because they're trying to draw more of an audience in. They figure if there's more controversy, and people like wrecks, so maybe if there's more of that stuff, then people will watch more. But they laid it down today. They fined him $100,000.
Oh, yeah, I saw that, yeah.
Deducted 25 points off his thing. I don't know. I saw this other weird headline. I mean, hopefully that'll curb some of it, because now he's, you know, lost a lot of points, but I don't know if that's going to fix it. They need maybe suspend the guy for a race or two, because that's bullshit.
When you
say I wrecked him on purpose.
He shouldn't be racing in the last one.
I wouldn't want to race out there with him.
I wouldn't either.
No, I'd be like, get that motherfucker away from me. I hit the brakes.
The stuff that happened with Danica Patrick's car was like an accident. That was different.
Yeah.
You know, like, you know, her car broke down, it spewed some oil and all that in some cars, you know, they that's something that'll happen on the track normally, you know. This shit was on purpose, and Jeff Gordon was absolutely wrong for doing that shit. I don't care how mad you are, dog. I mean, it's like, okay, why don't after the race is over, you go up and punch him in the face instead of purposely wrecking him, almost killing yourself and him. Not only him, yourself. You know, not only him, yourself, because you hit him, you lose control of your car, you hit the wall.
Yeah,
It's like he almost had like a death wish or something. To tell you.
No, and you could see that when the way they were talking, their next race, you know that shit's going to go down.
Oh, yeah, absolutely, and that's why I wouldn't let either of them motherfuckers race in the next one.
Yeah, so he went from like 6th place to 8th place or something like that with the points. And dude, he won $5.7 million so far this year. So when you fine him $100,000, that really ain't nothing.
No. I mean, honestly, I don't think they punched him enough, man. They shouldn't race in the next race. It's like, okay, you bumped him, right? Okay, it's like the Clint guy bumped him, and that's why he got mad. And it wasn't the first time he bumped him. Right. Jeff Gordon was like, well, fuck you, bam, and hit him. And I don't blame the Clint guy for going after him and shit like that.
No, I beat his ass.
I beat his ass, too.
I pulled him up on Yahoo just to see Jeff Gordon. He's 5'7", 150 pounds.
Oh, he would have got his ass.
I would have whooped his ass.
I mean,
150 pounds, 5'7".
I don't blame the pit people for being mad and all that shit, man. But, hey, that dude was going after him. He got stopped by security, man. I tell you what, if security didn't stop him, he would have got his ass whooped. Because he's a short dude. He's like a Tom Cruise short-looking dude.
Exactly. And here's something else I can relate with NASCAR. As I pulled up Jeff Gordon's his profile there on Yahoo, I see like the recent news, and Brad Keselowski got fined $25,000, which probably isn't nothing to him either, for in-car tweeting. Dude, motherfucker's tweeting while he's racing. Dude, I see people driving to work that piss me off. I don't want to get beside him because I see him like
swerving. And this motherfucker's going 200 miles
an hour.
Some crazy
in car tweeting.
There, man.
Dude. Damn, how do you do that with those gloves and your decks and that little thing?
215.
Dude, pay attention to where you're driving.
Oh, my God. Oh, shit.
Because half the track is past you, and like by the time you blink.
Exactly. Oh, man.
Shit.
Oh, God. Well, speaking of track, the BCS is definitely off track as Alabama got upset by Texas A&M last Saturday, and they are number 5 instead of number 1. But the new number 1 is Kansas State, number 2 is Oregon, and number 3 is Notre Dame, and number 4 is Georgia. The only 3 undefeateds right now are the top 3. And we are looking at a non-SEC national champion because I think Kansas State has Baylor and Baylor and Texas left. I think they'll win both those games. Oregon has Stanford and Oregon State. That's a little bit harder, but I think they'll win those games too, so... So I don't know who had Notre Dame has left, but it seems like nobody wants Notre Dame to be in the national championship anyway. So
yeah.
All I hear is like, oh, hey Notre Dame, you know, Blue says he hates Notre Dame too, man. So
yeah.
But man, Kansas State has come out of nowhere, man, and you know, just playing their schedule, playing good ball. The Klein, their quarterback, he's a Heisman Trophy candidate. You know, not impressive numbers, not like RG3 from last year, but impressive enough to where, hey, he's leading the number one team in the country, and hey, I'm all for a different conference champion, man. It just shows that there's talented schools out there.
Right, I like to spread it around a little bit.
Exactly. So that's getting to the nitty gritty, man. It's getting to the nitty gritty on that. And speaking of nitty gritty, we're gonna get to the nitty gritty and get into shout outs. And Vladz, I'm gonna give us some shout outs.
Cool. I'd like to give a big shout out to Elmo. I'm glad you beat those charges. someone was accusing Elmo as a bad shit, and then finally I just saw that those statements were recanted. That was false. Elmo did not do that. Can't be fucking up Sesame Street like that. God damn it.
Exactly, man.
It's nothing sacred anymore.
No.
Good Lord.
No.
So I don't care what, you know, his sexual preference is, but that's just wrong, man. I can't be believing. Can't be taking down Sesame Street and Elmo like that.
No.
Let's give out shout out to Robbie Joe for not showing up tonight in his new podcast, Level Zero.
Yes.
And of course, you already did mention that to Vic and to Blue and to Ace and to Tim Pan, all our other buddies on OFR who are busy doing other things, which is fine. Shout out to those guys for doing what they're doing, man.
All right. Well, I want to shout out, you know, to the He's Gone Rod and to Sherry's Joy and Scarfinger on their 200th Scarcasm live show. You know,
wow.
They did like a actual live, you know, on camera Q&A show last Sunday, and it was pretty awesome, man. I couldn't make it, you know, the Texans and Walking Dead and all that stuff.
Right.
But I submitted a question, you know, and they kind of answered the question, you know, so they kind of answered all kind of questions. So check that out. You know, they got it on the iTunes feed right now. And shout out to Alfred and all the Gamer Husbands on Gamer Husbands Radio. Alfred gave me a huge shout out on the last show. You know,
cool.
I enjoy their show and always tweet out on Fridays. You know, it's TGIF work day, you know. Download the Gamer Husbands and all that, so shout out to them, and shout out to everybody in the Open Forum Radio Network, and shout out to you for listening. Peace, love, and happiness. Stay open. Let's get it. Good night.
Woo woo.
'Cause I got a little cheap headset.
No, you sound fine.
All right, cool. 'Cause the other one, somebody said don't get a Triton, and I dropped that thing once and it's acting like it doesn't want to work anymore. Like I was using it on the 360, but it was working on the PC setting of the 360 setting. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh shit. That's the one where you like, those are the ones I was wondering, like, Terry, could you get off?
could you get off our call?
That's the one I was wearing at night, man. So I was like, that's why I got another cheap headset, you know, for 360, you know, but I want to get one where, you know, I can hear the game and everybody on the, you know, online too. So.
Right.
So.
Yeah, you gotta get that. In fact,
nah, man, on Black Friday, they got one on sale for $35 like this.
Dude, yeah, what have I got here? I got a... It's an older one. It's a Air Force X11. And I think you could probably get them for like $20 or something now, but...
Dude, that's the one on sale for... I guess I got the more advanced one of that on sale for $35, but the regular price is like 70 or...
70 or bucks, yeah, I know. They look cool. I need to get... And this is wired, which I don't mind the wired
ones. I don't mind the wired one either, because they say that's actually worked better anyway. But
that's cool.
Yeah.
But not... I was thinking about investing on wireless ones for my kids, because, man, they are ruining those little headsets. They only last maybe, like, 2 months. And, you know, there's $15. Okay, $15, $15, mm-hmm. $15. I'm like, man, you know what? I could buy you a nice headset.
Yeah, exactly. Instead of spending $15 on, you know, wasting my money.
Right, and that's $50 for the cheap one, $20 for the Xbox one, and you know, a couple of those down, I'm like, you know, I should have. There's $100. I, yeah, just pain in the ass.
Exactly. Nah, man, I think Walmart's doing the best deal, man. But no Halo 4. No, Target is giving you a $20 gift card if you buy Halo 4 regular price.
Really?
Yeah, but
that's good.
That is good actually. But like I saw like. Like Spec Ops Online is $15 at Walmart. The Transformers Fall of Cybertron War for Cybertron is $25. The NBA 2K13 is $25. But I can't get all these games. That shit adds up.
Then
I'll be in line for like 2-3 hours. They start this shit at 8 o'clock Thanksgiving night, man.
See, I know, and I'm not ready for that. I can't be going anywhere.
There's
Thanksgiving
no football
night.
On that.
Football is on. Plus, I've been eating turkey and drinking all day.
Dude, the first game of the day is Texas at Detroit.
There's no way I'm legally about getting in a car. I got so much tryptophan in my system.
And that's what I'm thinking,
alcohol.
Man. It's like I'm gonna fall asleep waiting in line and shit, man. Because I have to be there like at 6 o'clock probably.
Right, you get in a long line. You're just like, I'm just gonna sit down here and take a little nap. Let me know if it moves.
I think I may take advantage of Cyber Monday that way. Just like Blue said, you can just sit down and you do nothing. You have to go anywhere.
I never thought I'd be shopping online on a computer. You look back maybe 7 years ago that I'd be doing all my Christmas shopping online. I mean, I hardly even venture into a store if I don't have to.
Nah, man, that saves gas, that saves money, that saves...
Exactly. Because I'm like, you know, if I could go, and then I got to go to this mall, and then I go to that mall. When I can do that, I got to fight traffic, and then maybe I might not get the thing that I need, and you know what? I'm not even going to do that. Plus, you know, that's gas money. No.
People get ugly during Christmas, man.
Mm-hmm.
They do, man. Shoot, man. Well, I'll tell a little quick story on my, like, Friday deals.
Cool.
What's going on in the hot minute. See, Best Buy has had the worst window launch for Halo 4. They didn't offer?
No, just the whole...
Oh, the whole thing as a whole. Okay.
That's your
little hot minute.
That's my little rant. We don't even have to talk about the pre-order sales. If you have something else we can throw in, I was just trying to come up.
Oh, man, what's your thing on cable TV? Because that's my worst. Oh, my God.
Dude, I'm so pissed off at cable TV right now because I had this package where I had my phone, my internet... Why don't we just get into it? It's about the stupid packages that they have. And
I got you.
I think this is my last year with this cable company, and I only have one in my area, so I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to go to Dish or go back to some other landline for my internet. I don't know what I'm going to do.
That's cool. That saves way good into my worst. So cool.
Cool.
All right, let's go ahead and do it then. All right. We gave you a chance, Robert Joe. Now we're going to flip it. All
right. Wait, hang on a second. Okay.
All right, cool?
I'm good. Yeah, I was just waiting for this little, the Pamela thing to click over past 5 minutes.
Okay. All right, here we go. In 5, 4, 3.
following message is transmitted at the request of the Pennsylvania State Police Department. An unidentified virus strain is rapidly spreading across the state of Pennsylvania. It is believed that it will spread to adjacent states within the next 12 hours. Symptoms of this virus include initial nausea and vomiting, blurred vision, loss of muscle control, and unconsciousness. State College is also reporting that some of the affected persons are turning into zombie-like creatures. Because this is an airborne virus, authorities recommend that the following action should be taken by all members of the public. Stay indoors, turn off all heating and air conditioning systems, wear breathing masks to prevent catching the virus, have enough food and water supplies for sheltering for 1 to 2 weeks. Any residents not in the state of Pennsylvania hearing this message should also take these precautionary actions. Most importantly, stay safe in this situation. Unruly behavior will not be tolerated.
What's up, guys? This is Vladz from Open Form Radio. Go out and download Zombie World Order. Feed your brain. Feed your zombie need. Do it now.